So this patient has a recurrence of cancer after radiation. Now, they didn't specifically talk about what type of radiation, but they would like to know what routes they would have next since the recurrence is present.
Well, first step is to decide, is the cancer still in the prostate area or somewhere else in the body? And that's determined by an Axumin or a PSMA PET scan. And other factors that are used when that is ambiguous are, what's the PSA doubling time? What was the original Gleason score? Process of treating all kinds of prostate cancer is really defining what variant of prostate cancer are we dealing with. One of the most common mistakes patients make, and even doctors make, is assuming it's sort of one process on a linear timeline, and really prostate cancer is a variety of different, some spread quickly, some spread slowly, some are very sensitive to treatment, some are very resistant to treatment. These are all different types of prostate cancers. So it's first important to gather all the information and understand as much about that particular individual's prostate cancer before thinking of, now, how do we treat it? The treatment comes after you really understand what you're treating.
You mentioned an Axumin PET scan versus a PSMA PET. Can you explain the differences and how you see the imaging playing out in the future?
So Axumin PET scans were a significant advancement over CAT scans and MRIs to detect metastatic lesions, particularly in the lymph nodes, which is the first jumping off spot for prostate cancer. They're useful once the PSA gets up to around 1, somewhat more difficult to read than perhaps the PSMA PET scans, which are useful even when the PSA is as low as 0.2 or 0.4. So PSMA PET scans are not really on the market yet, although they probably will be shortly, and that will probably replace the Axumin PET scan given the fact it's got greater precision and accuracy. It's more accurate in the bones, whereas the Axumin PET scan is not very accurate in the bones. There may be select situations where we'll continue to use Axumin PET scans, but I would predict that PSMA will take over the market.
This next patient says they had an MRI and a biopsy that discovered only Gleason 6 prostate cancer. They had a PSMA PET scan that discovered 2 lesions on the ribs. My doctor wants to treat those lesions with spot radiation and hormone therapy. Am I right in thinking that further investigation is needed first? How specific is the PSMA PET scan?
I would say certainly you need further investigation. So let's assume that the PSMA PET scan is showing something in the ribs with Gleason 6. Well, basically, we know that Gleason 6 doesn't spread. So if the ribs are prostate cancer, which PSMA is specific for prostate cancer, how could we have disease in the ribs? Well, one possibility would be that there's another tumor inside the prostate that was missed on the MRI, missed on the biopsy, that has a higher Gleason score. But that should show up on the PSMA PET scan. So someone needs to go back and look at the PSMA PET scan and see if the hot spots in the prostate match the areas of where Gleason 6 disease was before. And if there's no unexplained lesions detected on the PSMA PET scan, then one has to suspect that there's some kind of a problem with the readout on the rib lesions and that maybe those aren't real. This is a diagnostic dilemma. We've got information that's clearly contradictory. Gleason 6 doesn't spread, yet PSMA PET scan says there's metastasis in the ribs. One of them is wrong. And so all the information needs to be vetted again, and someone needs to figure out why things don't add up.
Hey everyone, it's me, Alex, and our mascot, Hunter. You can check out his Instagram, Sir Hunter the Dow, at the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and in fact, if this dog high-fives me, high-five, high-five, can you high-five me? Thank you. You have to subscribe. Go subscribe to the YouTube channel. He even thinks it's awesome. Also, don't forget to visit our website, pcri.org.